Fortnite is a game a lot of people love, or it's a game a lot of people love to hate, and I myself am a little guilty of loving to hate on the game. But with that said, I've been playing a game a lot lately that is just like Fortnite, but has all the 80s vibes I need to fill my soul. Let's talk about a game called Radical Heights. Radical Heights is indeed a battle royale game. And what that is a game where a ton of players are propelled into one large area and forced to battle it out to the death. Players can collect loot, weapons, upgrades, and grab random packages lying around each level. Nearly every single thing in Radical Heights is just like Fortnite, but it's filled with 80s vibes and 80s inspirations. And I'm talking about the announcer, the hair, the sound effects, your clothing, your shoes, your short shorts. Every single thing in the game screams out 80s, and I know this might make me biased, but for some reason the game just works for me because of that. I can openly admit that, yes, I like this game much more than Fortnite for mainly this reason alone. The visuals and vibes just speak to me as a gamer in a much more intimate manner. And again, I know this may seem biased or even a really dumb reason to choose Radical Heights over Fortnite, but yeah, at least I'm owning up to that. I know it sounds weird, but have you ever connected with something more just simply based off its visual or physical appeal? I mean, I know I have. It is almost like clothing in a weird way. Say I try on two pairs of pants, and they fit almost exactly the same. Well, which one should I pick? Well, obviously, I'm going to pick the ones that I think look better. And so in this case, with Radical Heights and Fortnite, I have played Fortnite. I have played Radical Heights. They are basically pretty much the same game, but for some reason, I find myself more comfortable, let's say, in a Radical Heights type of pair of pants. Radical Heights is still in development, so yes, the game is very rough around the edges, but that's okay. Based off what I am playing right now, I cannot wait to dive into the full-fledged finished game in all of its retro 80s driven glory. And even with all of its similarities, yes, there are some differences that separate the two games. Some of my favorite standouts from Radical Heights are things like you can ride bikes and do tricks on them. You can bounce stupid high on trampolines. There are zip lines in the game. And the map itself looks like a giant TV set, and the whole game is built like a game show that you are a part of. Kinda like Super Mario Bros. 3, but with a live audience cheering you on.
I got him.
Oh, I got that.
Nice.
Really like a dramatic shot.
Yes.
If you're obsessed with the 80s like I am, I recommend trying the game. My nostalgia trigger goes off upon just seeing the game, so give it a try. And just so you know, Radical Heights as of right now is only available on PC and it is free, and I am hearing word of it coming out to other consoles in the future. After I'm done editing this video, I'm gonna slap on my short shorts.
Nah, you need the battery.
Put on some synthwave and enjoy myself some Radical Heights. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Make sure and like the video. It lets me know that you like what we're doing here and what we're talking about here. Make sure to subscribe. We are here doing videos at least 4 days a week. And on top of that, we do live stream 1 to 2 days a week as well. That's it. Thank you for watching and have a great day. I'll talk to you guys next time. See you later. Long live the 80s.